This is Mr. Schneider. Mr. Schneider is an architect and he has designed an office building for Mrs. Müller. Mrs. Müller would now like her building to receive a sustainability certificate. But who decides whether or not a building is sustainable? Therefore, Mr. Schneider will get in contact with Mrs. Fisher. Mrs. Fisher is an auditor for a building certification system. Her job is to carry out all of the calculations and documentation necessary for certification. But just how does Mrs. Fisher evaluate the sustainability of a building? Building certification schemes generally differentiate between a building's ecological, economic, and socio-cultural qualities. Each of these areas is systematically evaluated according to standardized criteria. These criteria combined reveal the sustainability of the building as a whole and whether or not it's eligible for a sustainability certificate. Let's look at an example. Environmental protection is very important to Mrs. Müller. For her, the ecological quality of her building is the most important consideration. For Mrs. Fisher to be able to assess this, she will need to create a life cycle assessment for the building. A life cycle assessment is an internationally recognized, standardized method for analyzing the potential environmental impact of processes, products, and even entire buildings. Because sustainability cannot be broken down to just a single number, such as CO2 emissions. For Mrs. Fisher to be able to create this life cycle assessment, she will need detailed information about the building, about each of the building's components, and about every individual product or material that has gone into these components. And all of this will need to be examined over an entire life cycle, from the extraction and production of the raw materials to the construction and use phase of the building, all the way to its dismantling, disposal, and recycling phase. Mrs. Fisher will not only need information about direct impacts on the environment, such as the acidification and over-fertilization of soil and water, ozone depletion, global warming potential, or various emissions, but she will need information about resource and energy requirements and about the disposal and recycling potential of each product. It would be impossible for Mrs. Fisher to collect all of this data by herself. This is where EPDs come into the picture. EPD stands for Environmental Product Declaration. In EPDs, all relevant data from a product's life cycle assessment that Mrs. Fisher needs for the evaluation of a building have already been assigned by the manufacturers to environmental impact categories. Just like life cycle assessments, EPDs are also based on international standards. EPDs are verified by independent experts and in Germany, almost all of them are published by IBU, Institut, Bauen und Umwelt. Since IBU also publishes EPDs as digital datasets, Mrs. Fisher's work will be made all the simpler, allowing her to easily create a life cycle assessment for the building, which she will then be able to integrate into her sustainability assessment. However, EPDs do not only simplify the evaluation process, they also help to streamline integrated planning. This way, even during the design phase, Mr. Schneider was able to compare various construction methods and options and to coordinate with other experts and planners to select the ideal combination of building products for Mrs. Müller's building. And this is why Mrs. Müller's building fulfilled all the criteria necessary to be certified as an especially sustainable building. Focusing on details, seeing the big picture, with EPDs from IBU.